Hey, it's Uncle Mark in the mothership with a three-string cigar box guitar. Yeah. This is the Pogues, and this is Dirty Old Town. Very, very simple tune, but it does have a weird key change in it, and they sometimes play it that way. Sometimes they don't. So I'm going to include it, and if you just want to take it out, that's fine. So here we go. By the gasworks wall, dreamed a dream by the old canal. I kissed my girl by the factory wall. Dirty old town, dirty old town. Clouds are drifting across the moon, as a browning on their knees, springs a girl from the streets at night. Dirty old town, dirty old town. To the original key. So what do we got going on? G, D, G, 42, 34, 24. Those are the gauges of what I play. Yours may be different. They're wound and they're electrics. I am also using my cube. So this is the settings. So as you can see, I'm on that clean setting, and you can see the gain's at 12 o'clock, and the volume is pretty low, just so you can see what I'm using. I'm also using my X-Vive, and this is my my X-Vive transmitter. That's what it looks like, right side up. There it is, the X-Vive wireless. I really like it. It's a very cool tool. Keeps me free. I like being free. So this song is really neat, and I kind of like it as a boom, chuck, boom, chuck, boom, chuck, boom, chuck, boom, chuck, boom, as a bass treble, you know. So I break this guitar up in half at the D string, so bass treble, bass treble, bass treble, and that's how I think this song has it. It's a good vibe for this. It also has an intro harmonica solo. You can do that in G. So if you have a G harmonica, you can certainly fool around with that. It's more a blow rather than a second key harmonica, which is a suck suck suck. So those things out of the way. I also like playing my G chord here as opposed to this one. So G, G sharp, A, important, B flat, B, C, really important in this song, and you can see it right there. C sharp, D, D sharp, E, F, F sharp, G. There's also another shape I want you to know, and it looks like so. It's also a G, just like that. This G here is G, D, G. This D, G here is D, G, D. So you would put your third finger here on the D. Put your first finger here. That's a G note. So it's from here. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There it is. And then you put your pinky on that G. And the reason I like it is because you can stop it. And the reason I mean you can stop it is you can press down, if you see real close, or let up. So press down, let up, press down when I want the chord, let up when I want to mute it. And what I mean by muting is, so I can go, stop. Right? So I'm not letting go of the chord, I'm just lifting up a little bit, but I'm still touching it like you would touch paper. You know, if I bring up a piece of paper here, it's just enough to move the paper. I'm still attached to it, but I'm not bending it. It's just enough to touch the paper. And that's kind of how you want to treat this, is so that I can go. And I like to be able to do that. That is very effective in starting and stopping. If you're down here, the only way to do it is with your right hand. Right hand palm muting would do that. But I can do this. And I don't have to use this hand to do it. So it's just a different technique. I also like this shape because my C is here and my D is here. And those are chords we're going to need. So the chords we need in this, before the key change, this is just straight ahead, G, C, which is a bar right here, that dot. So bar here, that's a D chord, so that's the seventh fret. We also need an E minor. And an E minor is made by putting your third finger on that B, which is the fourth fret, your first finger on that E, which is the D string, second fret, and open G. Very nice chord. You can play an E if you'd like. So you could just slide from D down to E. That would be B, E, B. But I like it much better with that open G string. That's a true minor. And I really, really like that much better. So we're just sitting on G right here. 7, 5, 7. Now, when you do a boom, chick, boom, chick, you can come back and play the whole chord. So you can go boom, 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 boom. You don't have to just hit the bass note and do two notes if you want. You can do all three. It's up to you. Depends on how you feel. But that's the vibe. Dirty old town, clouds are drifting, and that's the whole vibe. And you can continue that whole song out. You could do it, you know, whistle it. Okay? Whistling these Irish tunes or these old English tunes is very, very cool. Everyone will love it when they hear you do it that way. I really, really think that's a good way to play this, especially if you don't have a harmonica or you're not harmonically inclined. You can whistle anything you want. If you have a penny whistle and a looper, you could just penny whistle through this. It's a very cool song for that. So on the record, they do a key change. This is something they don't do live. The Pogues live is different. They play it straight ahead in D. I mean, in the key of G. But on the album, they do a key change into C, and just like in the intro. So what I'm going to do is go from Dirty Old Town and Dirty Old Town, and then go into the key change and show you how that works. So Dirty Old Town, what's the E minor? Dirty Old Town. They hop up, C. Now we're in the key of C. So in the key of C, these chords translated, G turns into C, C turns into F, D turns into G, and E minor turns into A minor. And I'll have this written out. It's going to be right over here, so you'll see how the changes work. So you can look at it, but it's called transposing. and it just changes the key. And it's actually very easy to do. One day I'll do an explainer on transposing. But right now all you need to know is C, which is on the 5th fret bar, F, which is C, F, C, G, which just slides up from F, so it's D, we just went through this, G, D, and A minor. A minor is A, E, C, or A, E, A. You can do it just like that, or add the pinky extra credit for the stretch. Okay, so give yourself extra credit if you're making your A minors like this. It's very cool, and it's a wonderful way to make A minors. In case you want to know and you really feel like stretching, another A minor would be this. And that would be E, A, C. It's a tough little chord to make, but if you feel like making it, that's great. So that's all you're doing, is you're changing key and then going right back into the key of G. So I'll go through that a little bit and whistle it one more time. Dirty old town, dirty old town. And we're going to walk up to C. A, B, C. G. We go back to the original key of the song. Saw a train, heard a siren from the dark sea. Saw a train, set the night on fire. Smelled the spring on the smoky windy. Dirty old town, E minor, dirty old town. And back. They only do that key change one time, so be aware, it only happens once. So if you listen to the album, you can play along with the record. This is the key it's in. It's really cool. I want to say thank you so much for everything you do for me. I have a PayPal link down below. It's a paypal.me/UncleMarkTips, and it's right here. And you can click on that, and it makes it very easy to donate to the channel, help keep the lights on. A buck a show is all we ask. I'm on Facebook at CigarBXBlue. Thank you so much for everything you do for me, and really, we'll see you again soon. Thank you so much.